Animal Breathing Adaptations. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Make sure to subscribe, hit that like button, and turn on post notifications so that you guys never miss on a video that I upload. Today we're doing Animal Breathing Adaptations. Topics covered in this video: what is breathing, importance of breathing, animal breathing adaptations, breathing through lungs, breathing through moist skin, breathing through body holes, and breathing through gills. Adaptation in animals. Adaptation refers to the evolutionary process by which species develop traits that enhance their fitness and suitability within a particular environment. This process occurs over generation as adventitious traits are passed down through genetic inheritance. Adaptation can be structural, physiological, or behavioral, and they help organisms explore available resources, avoid threats, and secure their place within their ecological niches. These adaptations often involve changes in body covering, eating habits, methods of breathing, and methods of moving. In our previous video, we have seen adaptation in body covering and eating habits. In this video, we're going to see different methods of breathing in animals. We can cover methods of moving in our next video. What is breathing? Breathing, also known as respiration, is the physiological process by which organisms take in oxygen from their environment and release carbon dioxide. It is a fundamental and essential process that sustains life by supplying oxygen to cells and removing waste carbon dioxide generated during cellular metabolism. Importance of breathing. Oxygen intake. Animals need oxygen to support cellular respiration, a process in which cells break down nutrients such as glucose to produce energy. Oxygen is a crucial component in this energy-producing process. Breathing helps regulate the pH level and maintain internal sustainability in an organism in response to environmental changes. The pH balance is essential for the proper functioning of enzymes and metabolic process. Removal of carbon dioxide. As a result of cellular respiration, animals produce carbon dioxide, CO2, as a waste product. Accumulation of excess carbon dioxide can lead to a drop in pH. Breathing enables animals to expel carbon dioxide from their bodies, maintaining a balance between oxygen and carbon dioxide levels. Energy production. Cellular respiration, fueled by oxygen, is the primary way animals generate energy for growth, movement, reproduction, and other metabolic processes. Oxygen is used to break down molecules and release energy stored within them. Thermoregulation. Certain animals, particularly those with complex respiratory system like birds, use respiration to regulate body temperature. Animal breathing adaptations. Animals inhabit a wide range of environments, from terrestrial animals to aquatic ecosystems and even aerial environments. Different environments have varying oxygen levels and concentrations. Animals have adapted their respiratory system to suit these diverse adaptations, ensuring that they can extract enough oxygen and release the excess carbon dioxide for survival. Some animals' breathing adaptation include breathing through lungs, pulmonary respiration, breathing through moist skin, cutaneous respiration, breathing through body holes, tracheal respiration, and breathing through gills, branchial respiration. Let us see breathing adaptations in detail. Lungs. Respiration through lungs is called pulmonary respiration. All mammals, birds, and reptiles breathe through lungs. This includes most terrestrial animals and some aquatic animals as well, like whales and dolphins. They have two lungs, which are connected to the breathing tube to the nostrils. Air is breathed in through the nostrils and fills the lungs. The lungs exchange the oxygen from the inhaled air with the carbon dioxide produced in the body. Then, the air containing more carbon dioxide is breathed out through the nostrils. In summary, breathing through lungs involves the process of inhalation, where oxygen-rich air is drawn into the lungs, and exhalation, where carbon dioxide is expelled from the lungs. Adaptation of lungs in mammals. Size, complexity, surface area of lungs can vary greatly among mammals. Small mammals like mice have relatively simple lungs, while larger mammals like whales or elephants have larger and more complex lungs to support their great oxygen requirements. Mammals that require more oxygen due to higher metabolic rates have larger lung surface areas. Some mammals, like humans, have diaphragm that helps with breathing. Marine animals like whales and dolphins have evolved specialized lung adaptations to facilitate diving. These adaptations allow them to store more oxygen and tolerate higher pressures, enabling them to stay submerged for extended periods. Some mammals, like camels and desert rodents, have nasal adaptations that help conserve water while breathing. The adaptation can include specialized structure that can capture moist from exhaled air. Rats, cats, dogs, horse, deer, monkeys, bats, whales, dolphins, and humans. Adaptation of lungs in birds. Respiration in birds is a highly efficient and unique process that is adapted to their high metabolic demands, energy requirements, and the demands of life. Birds have evolved a sophisticated respiratory system that enables them to extract oxygen from the air more efficiently. Birds have a system of air sacs connected to their lungs, allowing for a unidirectional flow of air through their respiratory system. There are both posterior and anterior air sacs, which facilitate a constant flow of fresh air through the lungs, ensuring efficient gas exchange. During inhalation, air is drawn into the posterior air sac, and during exhalation, it passes through the lungs and enters the anterior air sac. This creates a continuous flow of air that moves in one direction, allowing for efficient oxygen uptake and carbon dioxide removal. This system of unidirectional airflow is particularly important for the oxygen-intensive demands of flight. The bones of birds are not solid. They contain air spaces connected to the air sacs. This reduces the overall weight of the bird and contributes to the bird's ability to maintain an efficient respiratory system despite their needs for lightweight structures for flight. Example: parrot, macaws, hen, pigeon, crow, and penguin. Adaptation of lungs in reptiles. Different reptile species have evolved specific respiratory strategies that suit their lifestyle, whether they are aquatic, terrestrial, or arboreal. Reptile lungs consist of sac-like structures with fewer internal subdivisions compared to the more intricate alveoli found in mammalian lungs. When a reptile inhales, air is drawn into the lungs through the respiratory passage that leads to these sac-like structures. The walls of sac-like structures contain blood vessels. As air enters these sacs, oxygen diffuses from the air into the bloodstream, while carbon dioxide moves from the blood into the sacs to be exhaled. Example: lizard, turtle, tortoise, snake, iguana, and crocodile. Breathing through moist skin. Breathing through moist skin is known as cutaneous respiration. It is a method used by certain animals, particularly amphibians, to exchange gases directly through their skin. This method is possible because the skin of these animals is thin, permeable, and well vascularized. The skin of amphibians like frog, toads, and salamanders is adapted for gas exchange. It is thin and contains many blood vessels close to the surface. The skin is kept moist by mucus secretions and water absorption from the environment. This moisture allows oxygen to dissolve and diffuse through the skin into the bloodstream. At the same time, carbon dioxide, a waste product of cellular respiration, diffuses from the bloodstream through the skin and into the external environment. Cutaneous respiration is highly effective in environments with high humidity or aquatic habitats. The presence of moist on the skin is crucial for facilitating gas exchange. In drier environments, cutaneous respiration becomes less efficient as the skin dries out. Supplementary breathing. While cutaneous respiration is important for some amphibians, it typically supplements other breathing methods like lung respiration. Amphibians have simple lungs as well, but they may rely more on cutaneous respiration in certain situations, such as when submerged underwater or in environments with low oxygen levels. Example, frogs. Many species of frogs, include various tree frogs and poisonous dart frogs, use cutaneous respiration to supplement their lung respiration. Salamanders. Amphibians like salamanders often rely on cutaneous respiration, especially when in water or moist environments. Newts. Like salamanders, newts are amphibians that use their moist skin for gas exchange. Earthworms. Earthworms are other worms that breathe through skins. Breathing through body holes. The process of breathing through small openings called spiracles is known as tracheal respiration. Breathing through body holes, specifically referring to use spiracles in insects, is a method of respiration by certain arthropods. Spiracles. Spiracles are small openings or spores located on the body of an insect, particularly on the sides of thorax and abdomen. These openings connect to a system of branching tubes called tracheal that carry air directly to the body tissues, allowing for gas exchange. When an insect needs to breathe, it opens its spiracles, allowing air to enter the tracheal. As air enters the tracheal, it reaches the body tissue where oxygen diffuses from the air into the cells. Oxygen moves from areas of higher concentration to areas of lower concentration, enabling oxygen to reach every cell without the need for a circulatory system. Carbon dioxide diffuses out of the cells into the tracheal. When the spiracles are open, excess carbon dioxide is released from the insect's body and into the surrounding environment. Example, insects. Many insect species such as beetle, ants, grasshoppers and butterflies use spiracle and tracheal system for respiration. Archinids. Some archinids, include spiders and scorpions, have spiracles for respiration, although they tend to rely more on book lungs or other specialized structures. Myriapods. Certain myriapods like centipedes and millipedes use spiracles for respiration, although they can have varying degrees of reliance on this method. Breathing through gills. Breathing through gills, known as branchial respiration, is a method of respiration used by many aquatic animals, particularly fish and some invertebrates. Gills are specialized respiratory organs located on the side of the body, protected by body plates or gill covers in some fish. Each gill is composed of many thin filaments arranged in a way that maximizes the surface area for gas exchange. Fish actively move water over the gills by opening and closing their mouth or by using specialized mechanisms like buccal pumping. As water passes over the gill filaments, oxygen dissolved in water diffuses into the bloodstream while carbon dioxide from the blood diffuses out into the water. Oxygen is more concentrated in water than in the bloodstreams. This concentration gradient facilitates the diffusion of oxygen into the fish's bloodstream through the thin walls of gill filaments. Carbon dioxide produced by cellular respiration in the fish's body cells diffuses from the bloodstream into the water, where it is carried away. Example, fish. Almost all fish species rely on gills for respiration. Aquatic crabs, lobsters, shrimp, mollusks, including clams, mussels, oysters, and certain type of snails utilize gills oxygen exchange. Amphibious fish. Certain fish, like mudskippers, have adapted gills that allow them to breathe both in water and in air, enabling them to survive in both aquatic and terrestrial environments. Larva insects. The aquatic larva stages of insects like mosquitoes, dragonflies, and mayflies also use gills for respiration. That's it for this video. Make sure to subscribe, hit that like button, and turn on post notifications so that you guys never miss out on a video that I upload. And I'll see y'all next time. Goodbye!